Hello everybody, my name is Dr. Ferox and welcome to this little mini ramble today about disseminated intravascular coagulation, which is often just called DIC. It's also called dead in cage or death is coming, and both of these nicknames are both fair and accurate and not being melodramatic at all when it comes to this particular clotting catastrophe. So before we go too much into DIC, some brief notes on normal clotting in our vet patients. Normal animals have both clotting factors and anti-clotting factors floating around in their blood at the same time. The clotting cascade is a big complicated mess that I won't go into at all, but it looks a little bit like this. But all you need to know really is that it's there and it does its job very, very well. We have both running at the same time so that when your blood clots, it doesn't clot too much and that those blood clots will eventually dissolve at round about the same rate that the tissue is healing, because you don't want your blood to just clot all the time anywhere for any reason. Blood clotting is typically activated by exposure to the damaged tissue, and the damaged tissue have these little things on them that we will just call tissue factor. And all our clotting factors will bind to them and make a clot alongside our platelets. But all our anti-clotting factors will come along to make sure that that clot isn't going to occlude the whole blood vessel and that it's no bigger than it needs to be. Now, DIC is a catastrophic complication, but it always occurs secondary to something else. Common examples would be sepsis, burns, toxins, and especially in Australia, heat stroke. All of these things expose massive amounts of tissue factor to the bloodstream, which sets off lots and lots and lots of tiny little clots. They are everywhere, they are in the bloodstream, and they are clots. Now, having lots and lots of little clots is a lot worse than having one big clot because it's a matter of surface area. If you think of these cubes as an example, one big cube has only so much surface area, but if you break it up into its same components, the volume is the same, but the surface area is doubled. And that matters because the surface area of the clots is where all the activation happens. Now, when DIC is occurring, you begin to consume all the clotting factors that you have. Because you only have so many of these molecules floating around your bloodstream at any given point in time. So you start to use them up, but at the same time, you have activated all your anti-clotting factors. And they are not used up. They are just going to keep going. So for those playing at home, if you run out of things to make you clot and you have activated all your things to make you unclot, it should be fairly obvious what happens next. And that's spontaneous bleeding from anywhere. You might be tempted to think that, well, as long as the animal's not injured, it'll be fine. And that's sort of true, except most animals have microabrasions going on all the time anyway. Most of the time you wouldn't notice because they just clot and they get on with their life. But they might be teething, or they might have an irritation in their nose, or they might have something going on in their gut. And sometimes you will come back to find a patient who is dead in cage with blood sprayed everywhere like they're from some sort of slasher flick. Now, in an intensive care situation, we often monitor very closely for this in at-risk patients because there's a bunch of pathways in our clotting cascade that you can actually measure to catch this before you hit a catastrophe. And then they need lots and lots of plasma because this gives them all their fresh clotting factors, which are not used up, to try and return all their plasma proteins back to normal. And you do want to catch it early, otherwise they will be dead in cage. And we are not exaggerating when we talk about how dangerous this condition can be. So thanks for joining me once again on this mini little vet medicine rant. My name is Dr. Ferox, and I will catch you next time.